Ours is now an age of substance abuse, the age of ulcers and anxieties, at a time when medical research has raised us to a new plateau of good health and longevity. Far too many of us worry ourselves into early graves, attempting to cope with things in our own little personal ways, without learning a few great laws that will take care of everything for us. These things we bring on ourselves because of our habitual way of thinking. Every one of us is the sum total of our own thoughts. We are where we are because that is really exactly where we want to be and or believed we would arrive, whether we admit it or not. Each of us must live off of the fruit of our thoughts in the future, because what we think today and tomorrow and next month and next year will mold our lives and determine our futures. We're guided by our mind. Once one of my heroes, Earl Nightingale, was driving through Arizona and saw one of those giant earth-moving machines roaring along the road. It looked like maybe 20 tons of dirt might be in it, and it was a tremendous, incredible machine. There was a little man perched way up on top with the wheel in his hands, guiding it. As he drove along, Earl was struck by the similarity of that machine to the human mind. Now, just suppose you were sitting at the controls of such a vast, contained source of energy. Are you going to sit back and fold your arms and let it run itself into a ditch? Or are you going to keep both hands firmly on the wheel and control and direct this power to a specific, worthwhile purpose? It's up to you. You are in your driver's seat. You see, the very law that gives us success is a two-edged sword. We must control our thinking. The same rule that can lead people to lives of success, wealth, happiness, and all the things they ever dreamed of is the very same law that can lead them into the gutter. It's all in how they use it, for good or for bad. This is the strangest secret in the world. Now, why do I say it is strange? And why do I call it a secret? Actually, it isn't a secret at all. It was promulgated by some of the earliest wise leaders. It appears again and again throughout the Bible and other great books guiding faith, but very few people have learned it, understood it. That's why it's strange. And for some equally strange reason, it remains virtually a secret. I believe you could go out and walk down the main street of your town and ask one person after another what the secret of success is, and you probably wouldn't land on one person in a month who could truly tell you. This information is enormously valuable to us if we really understand it and apply it. It's valuable to us not only in our own lives, but in the lives of those around us, our families, employees, associates, and friends. Life should be an exciting adventure. It should never be a bore. A person should live fully, be alive. Everyone should be glad to get out of the bed in the morning. We should be doing jobs we like to do because we do them well. Once the great Grove Patterson made a speech as the editor-in-chief of the Toledo Daily Blade, he concluded his speech by saying something well worth remembering. He said this: "My years in the newspaper business have convinced me of several things. Among them, that people are basically good, and that we come from someplace and we're going someplace. We should make our time here an exciting adventure. The architect of the universe didn't build a stairway leading nowhere. And the greatest teacher of all, the carpenter from the plains of Galilee, gave us the secret time and time again. As ye believe, so shall it be done unto you."